country, and from prison to Grammy nominations and chart-topping songs. Del Fasane introduces us to an unlikely rising star.
He's a former rapper who calls himself Jelly Roll. He sings songs about the troubled life he used to lead. He recently won a Country Music Association award for Best New Artist, and he just turned 39. Nominated for 2 Grammy Awards.
Someone was asking me, what is the precedent for this Jelly Roll story? And I said, it's not really like anything.
Yeah, thank you, man.
We're definitely on our own island.
This is jail. It sucks.
Everyone I've ever been to.
If you're wondering where Jelly Roll came from,
so this is your own room right here.
This is it.
Oh. One difference is that the door's open right now.
Yeah. It still smells the same, though.
One answer is here, the County Detention Center in Nashville.
There was a time in my life where I truly thought this was it.
Yeah. And this is your future.
Yeah. And then coming here, you know, just after getting nominated for 2 Grammys, it just hits different. You know, it's just... I didn't think I'd get emotional, to be honest, but every time I picked this cell, just think, man, this is...
Even when I left here, I didn't have a plan.
Jelly Roll was in and out of facilities for 10 years, starting at age 14. Drug possession, drug dealing, shoplifting, aggravated robbery.
I knew that I loved music, and I knew it was the only thing I had any skill set in. I thought, I can't live on crime.
His real name is Jason DeFord, but when he was a boy, his mother gave him a nickname that stuck.
Your family called you Jelly Roll, or your friends called you Jelly Roll.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, to this day, my mother calls me Jelly. If somebody walked in here right now and said Jason, I wouldn't look up.
Growing up, Jelly Roll never pictured himself having a normal career.
I knew my father booked guests. I knew my mother struggled with drugs. So to me, this was just what you did.
When he wasn't getting in trouble, Jelly wrote songs, like this one about driving around and getting high.
Cocking a big body down south, I've been moping slow, staying smoked out in the Chevy, and I'm heavy and I ride clean. I'm wiping sticky off my dickies from the light green, the light green.
He started making informal hip-hop CDs known as mixtapes.
You're selling drugs to people and selling mixtapes?
No, I'm just giving the mixtapes away. I'm just like, yo, here's a sack of weed, here's a gram of coke, here's a mixtape. I rap too. It was like my business card. Even my drug dealing, to me, was always a means to music. I wrote hundreds of songs right here. I wrote Riding All Alone, of course, right here. I wake up every day, I hit my knees and pray. My mind is filled with pain, so many things have changed.
I'm looking at my life like it's an hourglass. Let's dance, spend every minute trying to kiss the past.
He was 24 when he left prison for the last time. By then, a prison guard had given him some news that changed the way he thought about his life.
He said, D4, you have a kid today. I said, what?
What?
He said, yeah, you have a child. And I was like, what's your name? And he said, hell, I don't know.
It turned out her name is Bailey. Like so many in Jelly's life, her mother suffered from addiction. Jelly is now raising her with his wife of 7 years, Bunny XO, a podcaster who calls herself the Trailer Park Barbara Walters. In 2010, Jelly Roll had his first minor hit, a hip-hop track called Pop Another Pill.
How loud in that song to show you where I was at in my mental space, how insecure, and how much I believe in myself. I ain't got no single, no potential for the relationship.
As a rapper, Jelly Roll sounded a bit like the southern hip-hop stars he admired. But when he started singing, made country fans pay attention. In 2020, he released an acoustic version of a ballad called Sam, which became his breakthrough.
I'm so damaged beyond repair. Life shatters my hopes and my dreams.
On YouTube, the video has been viewed more than 200 million times.
Tonight is the most special.
Yes, sir.
Night of all.
performed at Nashville's Grand Ole Opry.
I knew the moment I did, I made at least a small piece of history of this town. Unreal, man. This place is holding ground.
Songs like Son of a Sinner and Need a Favor make fans feel as if they really know him and believe in him. It's like Dale Henry and her daughter, Kelsey Roberts.
It just really touches your soul. When you hear him say, save me from myself, it just makes me think, it's such a pain in there. Right. You just separate the two of you.
Chapel is anchored by a song called She, about a woman fighting drug addiction.
But what an amazing full circle moment. You know, She was a song about the defending man from an artist whose first single was called Pop Another Pill.
It shows what God can do as you can. It shows how much change can happen in your life.
The windshield is bigger than the rearview mirror for a reason, because what's in front of us is so much more important than what's behind us.
These days, when Jelly goes behind bars, he's only visiting, and he's bringing a message.
For you, it might be welding. For you, it might be bartering. Whatever it is, find that thing. And it might just be starting with simply being a good father.
I'm trying to just encourage, inspire, and entertain. I'm just trying to get you free from that. My good juveniles, I'm trying to get you to understand that you're loved.
He may talk like a preacher, but he says he doesn't exactly live like one.
One of the things that people really relate to you for is not just that you have this sense of wanting to inspire people, but also this idea that you're still someone who's still trying to figure it out.
I think that it's cool to see vulnerability that way, and that we can all grow together, and that it's okay to not have it figured out at 35. Mm. It's okay to not have it figured out at 25. It's okay to not have it figured out at 15. Just know that you can figure it out and believe in that.
How do you feel about your success? Do you feel like you've earned it? Do you feel like you deserve it?
I'm starting to. I didn't at first. And I'm still dealing with imposter stuff. I'm still dealing with talking to my therapist about that. Do I really deserve this? I'm still a guy who's haunted by my past. There's a very dark hallway between my ears.
But sometimes Jelly Roll takes a minute to think about his unlikely journey, like when he phoned his mother a few weeks ago.
I'll call her addicted. I'll call her homeless. I'll call her from rehab facilities, I'll call her from halfway houses, broken down on the side of the street. Never got to call her and say I've been nominated for 2 grand. It was one of the coolest moments of my whole life.
Watch WUSA 9 News at 6 and 11 p.m.